let's see what values we can set for it, okay. So, now proceeding further towards our actual objective, what we did right now was a very general derivation. So, now we are going to look at what is called a perfectly matched interface, and this is by means of revision. So, what was our kx? We had defined it in this way, okay. This was in the previous few slides. Remember, this came from the, what was the motivation? I can show you that equation once again. Equation 2 over here, that was an equation of an ellipsoid, and the solution to the ellipsoid gave me over here the length of the semi-major, semi-minor axes are like this, and in parametric form I got an ellipsoid, right. So, and this k naught over here was omega by c, which I am just rewriting it over here, okay. So, I am just rewriting this for your convenience. This is my kx, this is my ky, and this is my kz, okay. And what is this k naught in general going to be equal to? We wrote omega by c, right, but omega by c is in which medium? Vacuum. But in general, we may not have vacuum, right. So, omega by c, and c in terms of material properties is 1 by root mu epsilon, right. So, this is in general k, okay. So, we will just keep this in mind because our two regions have different values of mu 1 and epsilon 1, okay. So, now phase matching condition required this and this, right, because the phases have to rotate at the same speed. Okay, so what does this tell us? So, we will just substitute over here. So, the first part is going to be omega square root mu 1 epsilon 1, okay. I am doing the first, this guy over here, 1, okay. Then what do I have? Square root of ex hx, right. We are calling this perfectly matched. Perfect matched means what? We had taken, it is our choice. We take ex is equal to hx, ey is equal to hy, and ez is equal to hz, right. Reduce the number of free variables, right. So, this is going to be now e1x, h1x sin theta cos phi is equal to omega square root mu 2 epsilon 2 sin. So, this is sin theta 1 cos phi 1, okay, and sin theta 2 cos phi 2. So, what are these, just so that you do not get confused, what are these thetas and phis over here? Do they correspond to any physical angle? They could, right? I mean, just take the simple case EH is equal to 1 everywhere, that is your free space, right. So, kz is k naught cos theta. So, if I have a wave vector making an angle theta with the z axis, it's giving me the z component of the wave vector, right. Now, region 1 and region 2, will the waves be traveling at the same angles? No, right. So, that's why I put sin theta 1, I have theta 1 phi 1 in region 1, theta 2 phi 2 in region 2. I am not getting into what the precise values are because they are not important, okay. So, this is the first condition, okay. What about the second condition? It is going to give me same thing over here, mu 1 epsilon 1 square root e 1 y, right, h 1 y sin theta 1 sin phi 1 omega square root mu 2 epsilon 2. You guys forgot to point out, I forgot a term over here, square root of e 2 x h 2 x. Sin theta 2 sin phi 2, okay. And the main thing to remember is region 2 is under our control, okay. So, why is this thing called a perfectly matched interface? And the reason is very, very literal. Perfectly matched. So, perfectly matched meant these things, that is what we had defined in a few slides ago. But perfectly matched interface, if you did not know anything about fancy PML and I told you interface is perfectly matched, what would you think? Impedances are matched, right. So, in other words, what is the simplest way to match impedances? make epsilon 1 equal to epsilon 2, mu 1 equal to mu 2. Let's suppose we do that, right?
So epsilon 1 is equal to epsilon 2, mu 1 is equal to
mu 2, okay? So we fix this. So what can, so these equations, they further simplify. So for example, this equation over here, square root of e1x h1x will become e1x, right? What else? The these mu's and epsilon ones cancels off, right?
And then I'm going to get a sine theta 1 cos phi 1 is equal to e2x sine theta 2 cos phi 2, and this guy is going to give me e1y sine theta 1 cos phi 1 is equal to e2y sine theta 2 cos, sorry, sine.
Okay. Right. Any further thing that we can do? So what is our goal? Our goal is, what is the goal of PML? Why are we doing all of this? R equal to 0, right? So we have to keep the expression for R equal to 0. Okay. Now, yeah. Yeah. There is no. Okay, good question. If I fix epsilon 1 equal to epsilon 2, mu 1 equal to mu 2, does it mean that there is no interface? If there is no interface, then R should be equal to 0, right? So we have to see that, right? But remember, I mean, this is, now we have gone to a non-physical situation because I have introduced these E1s and H1s, right? So, and they have made an appearance in the reflection coefficient. So it's not clear whether just epsilon 1 equal to epsilon 2 is enough to guarantee that these reflection coefficients are 0, okay. The properties of the material have changed via the small e's and small h's. There is an interface, yeah, there is an interface. It's because now I've expanded my idea of an interface itself, okay.